This is the container of chicken necks that I bought for the cats yesterday. And this is a book called The Natural Cat. It's the same book, I just have two different editions of it. This is a 1983 edition, and this is a 2008 edition. I believe I bought this one in a bookstore, or I got this on Amazon. And then this one I found in a used bookstore, and I didn't realize it was the same book. But it is kind of interesting to compare the earlier version of the book with a later version of the book. So when I was looking through these books the other day and researching information on teeth health, I came across this information on acceptable crunchies. It says dry food does not clean the teeth. It never has and it never will. No one claims that, not even the dry food manufacturers. I have met numerous cats formerly on an all dry food diet with the worst tartar in the world. To help clean teeth, Dr. Rowan recommends broiled chicken neck vertebrae. The vertebrae are the only cooked poultry bones that are allowed because they do not splinter, they crumble. Do not feed any other cooked poultry bone to your cat except the neck vertebrae. This, like all meat, must be cooked because of the danger of parasites. Now, I don't agree with that at all because obviously these cats are on a raw food diet and there are no animals in nature that cook their food. So there's quite a bit of information in this book that I don't necessarily agree with, but that's why it's always good to cross-check and cross-reference information that you come across. But anyway, to continue, no matter how expensive the meat, don't take a chance. Some of those parasites are incurable and fatal when they reach the lung or heart. Most cats prefer their chicken neck broiled or roasted as opposed to boiled in water. I suggest presenting the first serving in the bathroom on the tiles, or better yet, in the tub, because the vast majority of cats become extremely excited on sniffing the poultry and tend to revert to primitive behavior, drooling, growling, and muttering, dragging the piece away from the rest of the group even if there is no group present, pretending to kill it over and over again. It's fun to watch, and you may see a side of your cat that hasn't come out before. And then it has one word of caution. Too much chicken neck tends to make the stool hard, so never give an entire meal of neck vertebrae. Give one or two vertebrae as dessert after a half of a normal meal, to which you have added an extra half teaspoonful of bran and a teaspoonful of water. This will condition the stool and overcome the hardening effects of the chicken neck. Give only 1 to 3 vertebrae per cat once or twice a week. Okay, so now this is the 2008 version of the Natural Cat book. So we're talking 25 years later. And this one says, to help clean teeth and provide a super source of calcium, Dr. Rowan recommends broiled chicken neck vertebrae served as a treat. The vertebrae are the only cooked poultry bones that are allowed because they do not splinter, they crumble. Do not feed any other cooked poultry bones to your cat except the neck vertebrae. Most cats prefer their chicken neck broiled or roasted as opposed to boiled in water. Dr. Pitcairn and I prefer serving the necks raw because heat destroys the valuable enzymes, but some cats insist that they be cooked. Now, in the 1983 version that we just read, they cautioned against feeding any raw food to a cat because they were worried about parasites. Yet here in the 2008 version, they're saying that they prefer serving raw food. So this is why you always have to double check information, and at the same time you have to realize that information that existed years ago is not necessarily current. Like, we are so much smarter than we were 25 years ago. We're so much smarter than we were 10 years ago. It's always very important to keep learning. So this says, raw birds are closer to the cat's natural diet. If the bird is raw, you can feed other bones as well. In fact, Dr. Pitcairn once suggested I serve each cat half of a rock Cornish game hen. I respectfully declined, explaining that while a half a bird might be devoured in short order by the country cats in his neck of the woods, it would seem a bit overwhelming to our apartment kitties here in New York City, many of whom weigh very little more than the game hen does. At the time, I was thinking particularly of Marfie Lund, a dainty little shaded silver Persian who tips the scales at 4.5 pounds. Now, I gave the cats whole quail a little while ago, and Boo devoured that. He absolutely loved that. So this says, whether you cook the necks or serve them raw, I suggest presenting the first serving in the bathroom, on the tiles, or better yet, in the tub, because the vast majority of cats become extremely excited upon sniffing the poultry and tend to revert to primitive behavior, drooling, growling, and muttering, and dragging the piece away from the rest of the group, even if there is no group present, pretending to kill it over and over again. It's fun to watch, and you may see a side of your cat that hasn't come out before. One word of caution, too much chicken neck tends to make the stool hard, so I never give an entire meal of neck vertebrae. Give one or two vertebrae before or after half of a normal meal, to which you have added an extra half teaspoonful of bran and a teaspoonful of water. This will condition the stool and overcome the hardening effects of the chicken neck. Give only one or two vertebrae per cat one or two times a week. Now, when I've given chicken necks to the cats in the past, they really did not go for them at all. I tried giving them whole chicken necks, they refused them, and I also cut them into smaller pieces, and I don't think they ate them that way either. I don't remember them enjoying them at all. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take about half of these and I'm gonna roast them in the oven, and we're gonna see how they like them roasted. I am going to be roasting these 9 chicken necks. I am heating up the oven to 350 degrees. I have no idea how long to roast these for. So this will be an experiment. This is what the chicken necks look like after they have roasted for about an hour and 20 minutes and then cooled down. This is one of the chicken necks that I've cut into smaller pieces. The knife went through it really easily, and I actually tasted a piece. So it tastes like roasted chicken, and I was curious about the bones, so I wanted to know what would happen if I chewed like the bone, and I was actually able to chew the bone. They do crumble. I didn't eat it, I ended up spitting it out, but I'm gonna feed these to the cats and let's see if they'll eat them. I just gave each cat a piece of the chicken neck. Are they gonna eat it? Splash is kind of smelling it. Simba's stretching. And Boo says he's not gonna eat it. Splash might eat it. Is he gonna eat it? He's gonna taste it. Ooh, Boo's gonna taste his too. They should like it, it's fresh. I just moved Stella's over for her. Boo's going to check out Simba's. Splash is crunching it. Boo's crunching it. Stella moved hers onto the floor. Is Boo gonna eat it? Looks like he's eating it. He just ate it. Stella, you're not eating yours. Splash did not eat his. I just gave Simba a little piece. Is Boo gonna eat the other one? Okay, so Boo's the only one enjoying these right now. I could always give these to Hydrox, Ditto, or whoever's outside. But I'm just going to put them in the refrigerator because that's it. They had one. And what I'm also going to do is I'm going to go get one of the raw ones. And I'm going to cut up a raw chicken neck and we'll see if the cats like that better. I just cut up a raw chicken neck and these things are just so much easier to cut up after they've been roasted. Because the bones definitely do crumble. They're just easier to cut through. Look at Stella. Stella's jumping up on the chair. So I'm going to give the cats each piece of the raw chicken neck and we'll see if they like it better. Okay, so Boo does not want anything to do with the raw one. I put Stella's on her plate with her roasted one. She won't touch it. Okay, now he's smelling it. And there's Simba's plate and Splash's plate. No one's eating. Nobody's eating. Boo, you just ate the roasted one. You want the raw one? Gonna eat the raw one? Nobody wants it? Thank you for watching this Lucky Ferals video. If you enjoyed it, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you'd like me to post more videos. And please make sure to check out these other videos that were selected especially for you.